Tottenham is counting the cost today of riots that left buildings burned out, families homeless and a community in tatters. Hours of violence were sparked after a protest over the shooting dead of a local man. The family of Mark Duggan told Sky News in an exclusive interview this evening that they condemned the violence and they called for calm. We'll have that interview in full in just a moment. But first, our senior news correspondent Michelle Clifford joins us live from Tottenham High Road. Michelle.
Colin, quiet now, but a day of tension after a night of rioting which has left so many people in this area feeling shaken. The local MP called the activities last night a disgrace and questioned whether the rioters actually spoke for the people of Tottenham. The big hope now this evening is that the violence won't be repeated. History destroyed. This building survived the war, but not a night of rioting and violence in Tottenham. The store was still burning through the day. Police cleared the street outside amid fears it could collapse. From the air, the spread of the damage inflicted overnight was visible, and only as the hours passed did the full human impact of the violence emerge. Alex and Irina Paredes were forced out of their home by the encroaching flames. They don't know where they'll sleep tonight. Alex's work van was totally destroyed. He can't now earn a living.
This is insane, you know. I never thinking about it, this can be happen for me or my life. I know this place is, it was bad place for live, but how we can do.
Trouble erupted last night during a protest over the police shooting of a local man, and anger fast translated into rioting and vandalism. A double-decker bus, businesses, police cars, easy targets for those intent on making their presence felt. Riot teams and mounted police moved in, but the battle lasted for hours, leaving more than two dozen officers injured. Stores were ransacked, looters brazenly displaying their booty in the streets. And there was no let-up. The raids on shops continuing well into today, despite the heavy police presence, leaving many local people feeling outraged.
I just think, yeah, that the police them, yeah, let this place burn down like this. If it was Scotland Yard, yeah, they would have been there quick.
It's just a small minority of people. They've got a thing against the regime, like regime's the wrong word, but the police on any excuse.
Police say that they have a good relationship with us. Maybe they do with some people, maybe the elder people like myself and something, but they don't have a good relationship with the youngsters them.
The local MP has been out today pleading for calm, imploring people not to repeat the violence and take relations with the police back to the dark days of the 1980s.
This is nothing like the sorts of scenes that we saw in Tottenham back 25 years ago. Then there was a particular relationship with the police. This is an attack on Tottenham, on people, ordinary people, shopkeepers.
But the police have questions to answer. Locals say a peaceful protest Saturday evening over the shooting of 29-year-old Mark Duggan turned nasty only after officers refused to address their questions. Hundreds eventually ended up on the streets. Police were pelted with bottles and missiles and forced to set up roadblocks to try and contain the area.
What was a peaceful vigil by a grieving family was hijacked by mindless criminal thugs who set fire to police cars, who damaged local businesses, who destroyed people's homes. And I don't think anybody could have foreseen that such a peaceful and proper protest vigil would evolve into something like this.
In the hours before police closed Tottenham High Road today because of the danger from burning buildings, locals were out gathering their own photographic mementos of the night before. Burned out police cars, the must-have image. Hours of violence have left this area scarred, and the worry now is about what another evening will bring. Well, there are still significant numbers of police on in the streets around Tottenham, particularly here on the high road. They're now no doubt grateful for a series of downpours in the last couple of hours that have displaced significant numbers of people who'd gathered throughout the day. But there is no room for complacency. The tension here has been palpable all day. There is significant anger still directed at the police, not just about the shooting last week, but the events of last night. People feel that they simply have not had their questions answered.
Michelle, thanks very much. Well, our reporter Enda Brady has spoken to the family of Mark Duggan, who was shot by police last Thursday. He joins us now from Tottenham. Enda.
Well, I spent some time with the family of Mark Duggan this afternoon. They're really struggling to come to terms with everything that has happened to them over the course of the past 72 hours. They're grieving, and their grief has been compounded by everything that has happened on the streets of Tottenham last night and all through the early hours of today. Mark's brother, Sean, spoke to me, and he urges people in the area to listen to what the family want and to respect their wishes. We can hear that interview now.
Sean, first of all, just on behalf of your family, just tell me how you were feeling, given everything that has happened over the past.
We're all devastated at the loss of our brother, our son, our cousin, our friends. He's got a vast amount of friends. We're all devastated to hear about the mishap. We don't actually know what has actually happened. I suppose that is what is the most grilling thing for us at the moment, is nobody's actually come forward and told us this is what has taken place, whether we believe what they're saying or whether we don't. There should be somebody here putting my parents' mind at rest about what is actually going on. Like I said, the whole family's devastated. We don't want Mark portrayed as some kind of gangster. He's a family man, as you see from the true pictures that you'll see of him now.
What do you say to the allegation that a police officer was shot at?
I think it's rubbish. I think it's rubbish. I know my brother's not that sort of person. He's not stupid to shoot after the police. That's ridiculous.
You've seen what happened last night and into the early hours of today. What do you say to anyone who seeks to go and create scenes like that in your brother's name?
We're not condoning any kind of actions like that at all to be shown or for this to be taken in my brother's name. I've been listening to a lot of the news today where it seems to be the press who are generally saying that it is linked to my brother. Okay, there was some questions were supposed to have been answered. They weren't answered. Therefore, there was a domino effect from that, which we don't condone at all.
Would you take the opportunity now to speak to people in Tottenham? What would you say to them just for the next couple of nights? What would you say to people in Tottenham?
I know people are frustrated. They're angry out there at the moment. But I would say please try to hold it down.
Of Tottenham's